Hi, this video shows how to send an email from Access, Excel, Word or some other Office applications without Outlook. Because always when you use Outlook, then you have you always have to sign that that you are the main user. So this is one example. When I send an email there, the email is sent, and when I check my account, then the email will come in from this application. All what you have to do in this point is you have to take one component, COM control, this one, and to register. I will save this email component to my download site website, and you may register it on you may download it and register it as a COM control, and then you may run it and use it and embed it in your code. And inside the code it is like this, simple, quite simple. You have to say who is sending, a password, what's your sending server. So in this case, for this test, it was T-Online. And then set the port. If you want, you may set the port and enable SSL or not. Then you have a subject and or title and a text, and all is then there, and you will send it, and it's done. So for registration of your control, and you have to go into your application and say there at references, send underscore email send underscore for as a control. How do you see this? How does this control go on there? It's all normally set somewhere in there. For this, we have to register it. And this is done by this small batch file. Inside the batch file, there is it's written the it's the regasm command from your framework. It's on your Windows 10 system. At the moment, it's the version 4, framework 4. I think most admins will know what it is. And then there is the path of your of the element. Of the DLL file, this one, inside of some apostrophes, and then front slash TLB code, something like this. So I will first unregister it and show you how it will be registered. Go there, go to the administration, run it as administration, and then system will say, okay, the type is registered, the assembly, blah, 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 was sent to TLB export, and that's what you see there. Now this is the TLB file, and you connect the TLB inside your, in this case, Access file. Go there, go there, and then you will find the reference to the control in there. And I'll take the code from my website, and then you may use it as a email sending control written in .NET framework 4.6. Use it, and if you have questions, then give me a call or a comment on YouTube.